Hello everybody, thanks for watching. This drawing demonstration will show you how to add gridded walls to a two-point gridded plane. I'm using a gridded floor plane that was done in an earlier video. If you haven't watched that demo, I encourage you to watch that one first before watching this one. You'll need the following supplies: paper, red pencil, graphite pencil, eraser, straight edge, ruler, T-square, and a set of drafting triangles. I'm going to start by drawing a set of transversal lines at each corner of the floor plane. Remember, transversal lines are vertical lines, and in two-point perspective, they go straight up and down. With my floor plane being divided into five units from both angles, I will do an elevation also of five units. In the floor plane, I used 1-inch measurements. So I'll use that same measurement along the front edge to mark off 5 inches. First, I will complete the room. I will add lines from the top point to each of the vanishing points on the left and right. This will give me the front edges of the room. I then will complete the horizontal measurements by connecting each of those measured points on that front edge to the vanishing points on the left and right side, and this will give me a set of 5 rows on each of the 2 front planes. You can see that as those lines that measure back to the vanishing points intersect the transversals of the back edges, I mark points. These are new intersections that will be helpful in the next set. I want to connect those back elevation lines now to opposite vanishing points, so the left back elevation line will have points that connect to the right vanishing point, and vice versa for the other side. In order to keep my paper nice and clean, I've chosen not to connect all the way to the vanishing points. As you can see, I'm already getting a lot of lines being drawn. I'm also terminating those lines at that back elevation line, the transversal that represents the furthest edge of my room. If I've done a good job, those 2 top lines from the left and right as they move back to the vanishing point should meet at that back transversal. That means that I've done a good job in measuring and have been careful in my drawing. If they don't meet, something is wrong somewhere and I need to backtrack and redraw to correct. I will now add new transversal elevation lines from each of the points found along the back lower edges of the room. These transversals, remember, go straight up and down. I also terminate them at the top edge of that back wall. As I complete that left back wall, I switch to my graphite pencil to darken the new grid on that wall. I will repeat this whole process for the wall on the right once I'm finished. And there you have it, gridded wall planes for a gridded floor plane. Thanks for watching, everybody.